Hey, welcome everyone to this week's episode of the Amazon Files brought to you by Mommy Income. I am your host, Kristen Ostrander, and I'm so glad you're here. We had a couple questions recently come in from some listeners, and I wanted to address these personally and right here and now where we are in 2020. We are in September. It's, you know, been a really long and rough year as far as for everybody, not only with like what's going on in the world, but also, you know, COVID-19 and all this other crazy stuff going on. And so everyone that keeps asking me, I mean, this is a repeating question that I keep getting, is Amazon still a viable business model in 2020? And what's going on with COVID? And do you think it's a good time to be able to do this? Well, a lot of people are thinking about starting a side hustle, starting a business in 2020, because either they're laid off or they realize they feel maybe unsafe going back to the office, or they're at home because they have to be, but they still want to earn an income. And so I wanted to just address this right away, because I think it's going to help a lot of people clear some things up. And you guys know I am upfront and honest about everything. I don't sugarcoat this. I'm not going to give you the sunshines and rainbows version of, yeah, everything's awesome and great. I will tell you, of course, pros and cons, and the decision is up to you. But I'm going to give you cold, hard facts about starting Amazon in 2020, what's good, what's bad, the good, bad, and the ugly, and talk to you about this. Also, for those that are currently selling, you know, are you, if you're questioning, is this still viable, or you've got those days where you're hitting your head against the wall and you're like, gosh, I don't know if this is worth it. There's so much frustration and all these different things. So we're going to go through that. But first, I want to make sure I invite you to join the Amazon Files Facebook group with your code word hashtag yes. You definitely want to use this code word there because that's really important to join other people. It's free to join the Facebook group, and you can talk to other people, ask some questions. There's, you know, thousands of people in there, not too many, but just enough to where you can, you know, new and advanced sellers, people just starting, people who have been doing this a really long time, and they can help you answer your questions in the Facebook group. So go to mommyincome.com/join us with your code word hashtag yes, and that will help you to get into the Facebook group. So is Amazon FBA still a viable business model in 2020 and beyond? The short answer is absolutely yes. It still is viable. They're still letting people in. You can still come and be a seller on Amazon. The longer answer, which of course we're covering in this entire podcast, is it's a bit more difficult and expensive, but yes, it's still viable. It's still a good option. As far as a product-based business goes, there is no other place that you can sell more of than on Amazon. You just have this naturally built-in traffic. Every person that I know has the Amazon shopping app on their phone. It's the first place they go to buy pretty much anything. So if you have a product, or you have a product idea, or you're thinking about selling products as a product-based business, and you're not on Amazon, you're definitely missing out. So that's something that you need to be aware of. If you make homemade candles and you're on Etsy, but you're not on Amazon, you're definitely missing out on customers. If you're knitting blankets and you want to sell them on Etsy or Marketplace or whatever else, and you're not selling on Amazon, you're missing out. If you're making your own product, if you're selling other people's products, if you have a mom and pop store in a downtown someplace and you're struggling to make ends meet and your store is not on Amazon, you're missing out. That's what I'm going to tell you. There's millions and millions of potential customers that you're not tapping into if you're not on Amazon. Now, before you beat me up about big bad Amazon and everything else, it's just honest. We all know what is the first place we go when we're looking for products. Honestly, I go to Amazon every single time. Does Amazon have this? My local store doesn't, or I can't find this here, or I need this in 2 days. The first thing that I do is go to Amazon. So let's just be honest about that. Even in 2020, everybody's still buying from Amazon. And what do you think everybody did during COVID-19 when everything was shut down and you're quarantined and couldn't leave your house? You shopped on Amazon. Right? And so yes, it is still very viable. As a matter of fact, more and more people are starting to join Amazon. Does that mean that it's saturated? Well, we can talk about that too. But I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not going to give you sunshines and rainbows. I'm not going to tell you everything's going to be perfect and wonderful, and it's just going to be this honeymoon phase of match made in heaven. You guys, this is a business. No business is sunshines and rainbows. There is no perfect out of the box business that's just going to be awesome and you're going to skip down the road to profit and you're going to be making it rain with all of your hundos in the next couple of weeks. That is not real. That is not reality. That is not realistic. any business, whether it's direct sales, whether it's Amazon, whether it's an affiliate business, whether it's a dropship business, whether it's a service-based business, all of it requires some hustle. It requires investment as far as time and money, and you're going to have to put in stuff in order to get out stuff. So the road's going to be rough no matter which road you take. If you take an Amazon road, if you decide to do a service-based business, if you're going to try to do drop shipping, whatever it is, it's just going to be difficult. You know why? Because you're a beginner. When you're a beginner, you're going to suck. That's just the way it is. So you need to understand that as a beginner, you've got to be humble enough to make mistakes and to learn and to stick it out for the long run so that you can actually make yourself successful. 9 out of 10 people quit way before they see the results that they were hoping for. So I'm just going to be upfront with you about that. No matter what business you try to do, you're going to have to put in some work. You're going to have to put in some time. You're going to have to put in some money. It's going to be hard. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to stumble. There, I said it. No sunshines and rainbows. There's no easy button here. But is it viable? Yes. Is it profitable? Absolutely. If you're selling products, you need to sell them on Amazon. If you want to start products and sell products, Amazon's the best place to do that. There's going to be obstacles. There are going to be those days where you beat your head against the wall and wonder, what in the world are you doing? I do it all the time. But you still currently the best place to sell products. And if you go to mommyincome.com/firstsale, you're going to get a roadmap to your first sale on Amazon if you've never had one. It's a free step-by-step of how you can start working on getting your first sale on Amazon. I think it's a great place, but I want to tell you about what's different this year. What's different this year is there's a deeper level of security and verification processes for new sellers. This is a good thing. Although it seems a little bit more difficult for other people, it's a good thing. It's a good thing because they're verifying the ID and the processes and all the different things. They want to see your proper ID. They want to see your EIN numbers. They want to see matching addresses and proper business accounts before they say yes. This is a business. This is not just I'm fluffing around over here. They're taking it seriously. They want to make sure that you're legit, that all of your addresses match, that you're not just making something up. This is good news because it also helps keep other fraudulent type people away from Amazon because they don't have legitimacy. So another thing you want to think about with this is getting a PO box or a UPS store box instead of using your home address. The good thing about this is that Amazon is requiring that you show your name, your business name and address as of this month, as of 2020 September. Excuse me. So because of that, it's showing that you don't want to show your home address, even if you work from home. So you might want to get a PO box or a UPS store or a box or something like that. Here's the thing. This is a real business. And as it gets more and more legit, it's going to cost more. That's just simple. If you were going to open a brick and mortar store and you wanted to open a store in your local downtown or in a plaza or whatever else, you're going to pay up the nose to get that started. You've got signage, you've got rent, you've got to make the store look the way that you want to. You have to buy equipment and shelving. You have to hire people. You have to buy all the inventory to stock all the shelves and then open your doors. Every business costs money up front. If you got into this thinking you could do it for dirt cheap, that's not realistic. Yes, you can start a little bit at a time. That's how I started years ago, a little bit at a time. But as things have changed and you want to grow into more of a legitimate business that's going to bring you real money into your pocket, you're going to have to invest something. So even one time someone came to me, well, how do I start a business when I'm broke? Like, you don't. You get a job and you earn some money and you learn how to budget your money and save some to start a business. You don't start a business when you're broke because obviously you don't really know what it takes to be able to make a business go the way you want it to go. You have to have investment. Now, some of that investment can be a little bit of money and a whole lot of hustle. That's a lot about what I did when I started. I didn't have a lot, but I knew with the little that I had, I could try to make some money on that. So if that's you, you can do this. You can just do it at a smaller scale. Do not expect overnight results if you're bringing $100 to the table. Don't expect overnight results at all, first of all. But you have to have something to put in. Don't expect, you know, something so big, if you're only putting in a little bit of money, you can start. I'm not trying to discourage those people that only have a little bit to invest. You don't need thousands and thousands of dollars, but $500 is a good place to start. I mean, with the education and some of the stuff that you're going to have to buy up front so that you can make your legitimate business a reality, you're going to have to spend some money. Even direct sales businesses usually start off around that ranking. You have to be able to invest into some in order to get started. So those are things. The legitimacy of Amazon and verification is a deep level of security, and verification is the first thing that they have changed. So be prepared when you start your Amazon business or you're verifying something new that they're going to ask for umpteen things of verification as far as identity. They want to see your paperwork if you're an LLC. They want to see your tax ID stuff, all these different things. They want to see the addresses match on your credit card statements or on your bank statements as they do the address that you registered with Amazon. So making sure that all matches up. The next thing that's different and new this year that makes it a little bit more difficult to get started and get into Amazon is more category and brand restrictions. As different things come up, different liability issues with Amazon, they've been sued many times for different things, fraud or just all kinds of different stuff. They are restricting more and more brands and categories. So there's a lot of big brands that are saying, we no longer want any third-party sellers, and they're trying to get restricted on Amazon, and that's taking its toll as more and more brands decide they're either pulling from Amazon or they're representing their own brand and they don't want any third-party sellers. That's completely up to them. They can do that. They're allowed to do that, and it just makes it harder for what you can sell. Also, category restrictions. They don't want anybody and everybody jumping in on, let's say, cell phone cases because there's 100 billion cell phone cases. Or when it comes to the baby category, there's a lot of recalls and a lot of safety precautions. And so they want you to apply for certain categories in order to be approved. When you're new, you have no metrics. Metrics are feedback, your reviews, your seller stats, your return status. Well, it's kind of like your credit score. When you turn 18, all of a sudden you have a credit score, yet you've never had any credit. You have a low score, not because you're bad, but a low score because you don't really have a history. And so they want you to build a little bit of a history. I know it seems like a catch-22 that you're trying to build a history with a company, yet you haven't sold anything yet. So it's kind of this beginner stage. But so many categories are restricted, and even ASINs are restricted. That doesn't mean you can't. It just means you have to get a little bit more creative in the beginning. You have to be willing to be humble enough to be a beginner. You don't get to see what's behind door number 3 when you haven't even peeked behind door number 1. So be patient with yourself when you're starting. Also, there's brands are restricted in selling in lieu of Amazon themselves. So brands are restricting third-party sellers because they want to sell their own brand on Amazon, which is perfectly fine. But then there's also more and more brands deciding to do this, which makes it a little bit more difficult to sell any and every brand that you want. Also, vendors are restricting the number of people that can sell on Amazon. So although they're not saying no Amazon sales anymore, sometimes they're saying, oh, we have 10 Amazon sellers already, and that's our maximum limit. Of course, that helps with bundles. If you're able to bundle some things together, then you can also approach that way. But it's getting a little bit more difficult. That's actually a good thing. If you are willing to do the work, you're willing to jump through the hoops, and you're willing to be patient with this, the outcome and the payout is huge. But most people quit when they start opening this stuff up, or they're starting researching Amazon, and they realize there's all these hurdles and all these different things. The barrier to entry is starting to get larger, and it's a little bit more complicated. If you are willing to stick it out and get through some of the weeds of getting into Amazon, the benefit can be absolutely huge. But I ain't gonna lie, it's not gonna be as easy as just, hey, I'm gonna open the door and walk right through it. There's gonna be several doors and several hurdles that you have to get over in order to get your account up, running, in good standing, making money, getting into different categories. It's just going to take a little bit of time, and that's just going to be okay. Also, Amazon recently has extra verification of products and brands. I swear every single one of my clients so far has had issues with branding and with UPC EAN codes and with GTIN exemptions and all these different things. These have all changed within the past 12 months. Not only changed once, but changed several times Amazon has changed their policies. Now, officially, they haven't changed all of their policies. They just changed the way that they're enforcing certain things. So it's just super frustrating. I'm going to be honest. I'm frustrated too. I can barely keep up with Amazon saying one thing to one person and another thing to another person and not adhering to their policies. But I digress, because it's their playground and we have to play by their rules. And unfortunately, they're as clear as mud sometimes. And that's something you're going to have to deal with Amazon forever. You're playing on their playground. They decide what the rules are, and you decide either you want to play on the playground by the rules or you don't. And they don't owe you anything if you don't. It just is the way it is. So you have to just decide that that's okay with you and that you're willing to walk within the parameters that they set you. Now, talking about the brands and product verifications that they're doing, unrecognized brands on Amazon are being forced to prove authenticity with either photos of the packaging or something like that. So say you pick up something at Dollar General and you want to list it on Amazon because it's not on Amazon and you don't see it anywhere else, but it's like some no-name brand no one cares about, right? It's Dollar General, it's a few dollars, you're thinking you could upsell it for, you know, 10, 15 bucks or something like that. And it's got a UPC code on it, but it's, you know, some generalized brand no one's heard of. You go to list it on Amazon, you type in the UPC code and the brand, and then Amazon gives you this error. And it says, this brand is unrecognized. If this is your brand, please proceed with brand registry. If it's not your brand, you know, please open a case and or open a seller support case and, you know, send us images of this product. They want to verify that the UPC code that you're entering in or your EAN number that you're entering into Amazon and the brand name matches the product you're sending in. So they're asking you to verify these things if it's a very new to Amazon product. This does not matter if it's a bundle or if it's a single unit item that you've never sold before. If it's something that's never been on Amazon yet and you're listing it with a brand new UPC or EAN code and a brand name, they're going to do this to you. This is a new step. This is a new step that they're asking people to do so that they can get proof that the products you're saying are the products that they are. They're verifying that. They're asking for photos and things. So what does this mean for bundlers? You guys know I love wholesale bundles and I'm still the wholesale bundle queen, and that's just the way it's going to be. But this is proposing a problem for people who are trying to either get GTIM exemptions because they're hand making things, or they're using generic brands, whatever that is, but they're still asking you to do packaging. This is why the custom packaging training is now included in our wholesale bundle system, because this has become a new thing that Amazon is verifying. They want to see EAN codes or UPC codes, or they want to see the actual product either with a hang tag or some sort of proof that this item is what you say it is. And we can't be mad at them for that. Let's be honest. We can't be mad at them for verifying products that we say are what they are and that the customers are trying to get the right thing. If you're listing something that's going along with some UPC code that then the customer is getting something completely different and Amazon hasn't verified, then that's on them, right? And so they have to take the heat and the refunds and everything for that. So they're adding an extra layer of protection and annoyance on our part of verifying that your products are what they say they are. So you're going to have to invest a little bit of extra money to maybe get, if you're, especially if you're doing bundling or you're doing something private label, which if you're private labeling, you're already spending money on packaging and things like that, to make sure that your product is verifiable by Amazon via a UPC code or some sort of GTIN exemption, that you're showing that it's a professional packaging and things like that. So for more information, you can get the custom package training on our website, mommyincome.com, go to the classes tab or the courses, and you can choose the custom packaging training from there. But Amazon's also, this is another thing that Amazon is moving towards. They're moving towards brand registry for all brands. I've been saying this for over a year. And so if you've been listening for over a year and you still haven't done your brand registry or haven't pursued that, I'm saying it again. And if you get caught with your hand in the cookie jar when all of a sudden Amazon says every brand has to be registered or they can't be on Amazon, and you don't have a registered brand at that point, joke's on you, right? I mean, I love you guys. I'm trying to help you now before it's too late. And I can hear some of you guys go, I can barely keep my business off the ground right now. I don't have a lot to invest. How am I going to do this? Well, the choice is yours. Invest into IP Accelerator, which is Amazon's kind of fast start way of using a lawyer to get a trademark so that you can get your brand registered. You need a US trademark to register your brand with Amazon. Now, if you're just buying something wholesale that's not yet on Amazon, you don't need to register that brand. You just need to show them the packaging with the UPC codes if you're doing single unit items. So it's going to take another hoop to jump through to prove, you know, you show them a picture of the item. Here's the UPC code. Here's the item. No big deal, right? That brand's not registered with Amazon. It doesn't have to be. But if you're bundling or if you're bringing your own products to the marketplace via white label, private label, custom made items, handmade items, your own bundling, whatever it is that you're doing there, and you want to register a brand with Amazon, you're going to need a US trademark. That takes 9 to 12 months on your own, doing it yourself. I did my very first one, do it yourself on your own, submitting all the things, and it took 9 months. The second one that I did took, it's still ongoing because there was some issues with it. So I had to get an attorney to help me fight the case, well, submit some appeal or whatever else. So that's still ongoing and we're going on almost 12 months. So your results may vary, but if you use Amazon's IP Accelerator program, they will hook you up with a lawyer of their choose. You can choose one off their list. Go to IP Accelerator on Amazon and you can pick an attorney from their list. I know Ideal Legal is a lot of one of the attorneys that or firms that a lot of my clients have used and been happy with. And for about $800 for one category, you can file your US trademark. If you use IP Accelerator, then Amazon will allow you to register your brand before you get your trademark officially. So you can use your registered brand through Amazon before you get that actual paperwork. So you're cutting yourself off of 9 to 12 months. It's as little as 2 weeks right now. I think sometimes it takes up to 30 days. But whatever that is. Now, I suggest if you don't have the money, you can do it yourself. I think it's less than $400 to do it yourself on the USPTO website to file your brand registry. If you guys are in the Amazon Files Hub membership site, you already have this training for brand registry in there. The step-by-step process that you need to take in order to register a brand, including getting a trademark and all those things. So, this is what Amazon is moving towards. Why? Because again, another layer of professionalism, another layer of protection. It takes a lot to get a US trademark. It takes either time or money or both. And if you're serious about your business, and you should be, especially for the long term, then Amazon knows that you'll be willing to invest in that. And of course, anytime you're dealing with the government, everything is verified. They're verifying all your information. They're verifying whether or not somebody else has this trademark, whether it's trademarkable at all, in specific categories, all these things. So it's another level of legitimacy. So if you make it through the door with all these things, you're like top level legit here. You know, that's exactly what they're going for. If you're looking for a long-term sustainable business that's going to put consistent income into your pocket, these are the steps you have to take, not right away and not instantly. You can start on Amazon right now by just selling used books from book sales and your own garage and whatever else for pretty cheap. You can literally start your account probably right now. I understand that there's a will, there's a way, and there's still an easier, faster, cheaper way to start on Amazon, absolutely. But your goal needs to be to work towards top level legitimacy, getting a brand. I don't care if your brand is ABC Good Gifts, whatever. I don't care if it's, you know, X and Y, you know, party supplies, whatever. I don't care what you're doing. You're doing auto parts. You're doing this, that. Get some random brand name that you don't necessarily care about. It's not like you're trying to be a household name. And if you are, then think seriously more about your branding for sure. I mean, get a professional logo, get a professional, you know, those types of things. Make sure you have a website or a Shopify store. If you don't have a Shopify store, mommyincome.com/Shopify, you can get a Shopify store there as well. But all these different things, you need to be more legit. So can you still start on Amazon with, you know, is it still viable? Can you still do retail arbitrage? Can you still do wholesale? Is there room? Is it too saturated? The question remains there of, is it too saturated? Well, it depends on what category you're selling in. I mean, you've got to do your research and decide what category you're selling in and is there room for another seller there? Well, can you do it better? Can you do it faster? Can you do it cheaper? Can you do it different? Those are the questions you have to ask yourself. I'm telling you there's room for everybody, but you can't sell the same exact products that somebody else is selling and expect to get on page one right away, especially when someone's got 10 years on you, right? So you have to be a little bit more creative, or you have to just get into the data. There's different things. How do you know if it's even right for you? Because there are places to start with no restrictions. You can still start with retail arbitrage. You can use straight up wholesale. It's all still fine. You just need to remember that you're going to be dealing with tough competition, race to the bottom prices. Your margins aren't always going to be, if you're shopping the clearance at Target and sending stuff into Amazon FBA, don't count on that same exact margin to be there when your stuff hits the warehouse. The reality is that 100 of your other seller friends are hitting the clearance at Target as well. They're sending the same things in, and then all of a sudden everyone wants the sale. So they start racing to the bottom, and now you've made 10 cents rather than $2 or whatever it is you were trying to make to begin with. You're going to have IP claim issues if you're sending in retail arbitrage items as well, because sometimes these brands are restricted, or they'll send you cease and desist letters of stop selling our stuff on Amazon because that's all they know how to do. Possible restrictions automatically. I've heard nightmare stories about people sending hundreds of thousands of dollars of stuff into Amazon. Amazon all of a sudden says, nope, this one's now restricted after you send in your inventory. It's terrible, but it happens. So constantly watching your numbers and things. But there are places you can start right now. Books, kitchen, home goods, lawn and garden, I think auto accessories, sporting goods, these are all open categories without serious restrictions. So not everything's restricted. You don't have to work that hard to get started, but just have the long-term plan in mind, because getting started and just dipping your toe into the Amazon FBA waters and then actually creating a long-term sustainable business is different. So if you're just trying to dip your toe in the water, just take it super slow and figure out if it's right for you, because honestly, this isn't right for everyone. This type of business is not ready right for everyone. Who can do it? Anyone. Anyone can do this business. Kids, teens, moms, stay-at-home moms, stay-at-home dads, disabled veterans, seniors, empty nesters, retirees, full-time job, you know, whatever you have, small town, big town, anywhere in the world. Yes, you can do Amazon FBA. If you've got a tax ID number, an internet connection, and products to sell, you can sell on Amazon. But why should you choose Amazon? Is this something that you just heard about that maybe you could make good money, or people are making $1 million on Amazon? I should try this thing. Do you want to run a product-based business? Because that's what Amazon is. You're moving product, and whether you're doing it physically yourself or you're sending it to a prep center or some sort of prep facility, or somebody else is doing that kind of work for you, great, but you're still dealing with a product-based business. And if you don't want to sell products or deal with inventory or cardboard or shipping or things like that, then maybe this isn't the business for you. There's a relatively small learning curve with Amazon, and you can start with very little money, but you're going to need some. It is worldwide. And compared to starting other businesses like a brick and mortar store or, you know, things like that, it's a pretty relatively low startup costs. You know, you really don't have to hire anyone right off the bat. You know, there's all kinds of different things to think about when it comes to that. So it's very viable and still a great business opportunity, especially in 2020. It really is. The Amazon needs more products from third-party sellers, but the barrier to entry has just grown a little bit. You have to be realistic about the time it takes to do FBA. Even people that are doing it and have been doing it for a while, start with 7 hours a week. That's 1 hour a day to work on your business. But ideally, you want to have 20 hours in or more. You know, you've got research and product sourcing and prep and shipping and account management and bookkeeping and learning and troubleshooting and, you know, all these different things to think about when it comes to Amazon FBA. So you want to make sure that you're giving yourself a realistic expectation of running a business. Because I want to remind you again, this is running a business. Regardless of how you look at it, Amazon collects tax information from you, and they were going to send you a 1099 at the end of the year for any sales that you make. That is a real business, my friends. This is not cash under the table that you don't have to worry about. They are going to charge you storage fees. They're going to charge you money for different things, and you're going to have to pay those fees. So just thinking about that. What kind of investment does it take? You can start with $500 or less, honestly. but you're going to need some education. You're going to need some tools and equipment, some prepping and shipping supplies. Even if you're doing used books to start out with or whatever it is, you're going to need some inventory. You're going to need to invest money in your business. It's a business. You can't just start from nothing. You've got to be able to sell product because it's a product-based business. So you're going to need product to sell, inventory, books, whatever it is you're going to get your hands on, wholesale items, your own items, something you custom make, whatever that is, it's going to cost you some money. Education-wise, go to startfbatoday.com for $97. You can get the beginner's Amazon course that we have here at Mommy Income. And it's $97 to get started. You can start your business with $97 and have the rest of it to go to inventory and tools and whatever else you need. Some of the stuff you might already have, but you're going to at least have to start with something. It's you can't sell products that you don't have. So you have to be able to invest in products, whether it's a little tiny amount to start. You can start wholesale for $300 or less in most places. So that's not an excuse either, but you're going to have to invest in something. And remember that you're going to have to keep investing. This isn't a set it and forget it. This is inventory sells, you have to ship in more inventory. As inventory sells, you have to buy more and ship more. This is a product-based business, so just keep that in your mind. Now, your realistic expectations of income. Now, I've seen this all over YouTube and all over the internet as far as when COVID-19 really hit and people were talking about, oh, how do you make fast money from home? And I was laid off and this and that and the other thing. And I had a client come to me and say, well, I want to replace my income in 3 months. I have to take a deep breath for a second. I hate breaking news to people that comes like that, that people think it's going to be that fast. Honestly, I've had people doing this for several years before they even replaced their half of their monthly income. It really depends on how much you can put in. It also, you have to give yourself the beginner's learning curve. This isn't, you're not going to waltz right into Amazon, set up all your accounts, get everything going and start rocking, you know, $30,000, $40,000 in sales next month. Like, let's be realistic. It's not happening. You know, in order to get the kind of income that you want, it's going to take a while to grow. You're going to have to work harder. You're going to have to work a little bit more. It doesn't just happen. So if you're working a 9-to-5 right now and you want to get out of it, you're going to have to work a 9-to-5 and then you're going to have to work a 6-to-10 at home on your home-based business until you can find the middle where you've make enough to quit. And upcoming on the podcast in the next couple of weeks, you're going to hear from somebody who has done this and he had to do his, what I call the double hustle, work all day at the 9-to-5, work at the corporate job, then come home and on nights and weekends, you're hustling to build your business. I think it took him 3.5 years. We're going to hear from him in the next couple of weeks. So stay tuned for his story because he is still doing mostly retail arbitrage and he has made that his business model, and I can't wait to hear from him. So wait a couple of weeks and make sure you're, you know, subscribed and you're listening because he's got a great success story. But again, realistic expectations. Don't expect a $1 million paycheck on a minimum wage effort. Don't expect big numbers if you're only investing small ones. It takes time to build. So keep your expectations at the level that they need to be. If you're a beginner, expect beginner results. If you've been doing this a while and it's time to up your game, spend a little bit more money on inventory, refine what you're buying and continue doing it. Your reasoning needs to be important too. Do you just need cash ASAP or you're looking to earn some income from home or you're replacing your current income, whatever that is, make sure that your reasoning lines up with I need to pay my rent next month because that's not going to be it. So hopefully that's not your reasoning. But if you're trying to just replace the job or earn a steady income, give yourself some time. So when it comes to all this, with all the changes and all the barriers to entry that Amazon is doing, it, you have to ask yourself some questions. Analyze the time it will take to learn and practice and perfect selling online. Are you willing to risk your time and money and learn the necessary rules and skills to become successful? Let me repeat that because that's super important. Are you willing to risk time and money to learn the necessary rules and processes to become successful? Because those are skills you have to learn. They don't just come naturally. It's not just if A plus B equals C, 2 plus 2 equals 4. it's not as simple as that. You've got to be able to, you have to be willing to make mistakes. You have to be willing to lose a bit of money. Oh, yes, I said that, lose money. Guess what? Most businesses aren't profitable for 2 to 3 years after starting operation. Now, that's not my story. I was profitable from the very beginning, but I took it very slow. I mean, I'm like 11 plus years into this already, but taking it very slow, because if you work slow, you screw up slow. If you're stepping big, you're going to fail big at first, you know, to just try to, and not everybody's going to fail. I'm not saying that everything's a failure, but you have to be willing and humble enough to learn and practice. And you're not going to be good at all of this stuff right off the bat. There's going to be things you don't know. There's going to be things that trip you up. There's going to be things you don't understand. There's going to be things that frustrate you, I promise, because Amazon is frustrating sometimes. That's just the way it is. But you have to be willing to put in the time and effort in order to become successful, because success just doesn't happen. You have to become successful at something, and that takes practice and consistency over and over again. So just know that this business model is still very viable, and I still highly recommend it if you're going to sell products. There's other business, if you guys want to have a consultation about other business opportunities and other business models, I have 1,000 of them in my head. We can have a conversation about that. mommyincome.com/coach, and you know, schedule a coaching call, and we can talk about, if you don't want to do a product-based business, what's out there for you? Because there's plenty of opportunities to make money if you don't want to deal with products. But as an Amazon FBA business, I think 2020 and beyond is going to be great, because Amazon's doing all these restrictive things to protect both buyers and sellers from fraudulent activities, from unscrupulous competitors, and different things like that. So it's a good thing, but it also means you're going to have to spend a little bit more time and a little bit more money to build a long-term successful business model. I mean, it's just a little bit of time and a little bit of money. So don't worry about it. And just, instead of complaining, just do it. Either 1 year from now, you could have a really rocking Amazon store, or you could still be sitting on the fence going, gosh, should I still start this Amazon business? Then you're going to be asking, is it still viable in 2021, 2025? The day is today. So if this is something you want, and your why is really important to you, and you want to stop thinking and dreaming and start doing, then today is your day. mommyincome.com/firstsale to get that infographic to get you started on your journey to Amazon. If you're already selling on Amazon and you want to up your game, check out Wholesale Bundles. Wholesale Bundles was a game changer for the business. Game changer. Before, I felt like maybe we were just dipping our toes in the water. When we started to do Wholesale Bundles, it was a game changer for sure. So wherever you're at in your journey, yes, this is still viable, but just know that you've been given the truth, that it's just going to be a little bit harder and a little bit more expensive, but it's still doable, and it's still a great way to earn great income from home. Just be patient with yourself and have realistic expectations. But I know you can do this, and I'm here to help. Don't forget the Facebook group, mommyincome.com/join us. Code word is yes. Yes, it's still viable. Yes, you can do it. Yes, I believe in you. And I would love to talk to you more about that if you want to chat. So thanks. We'll see you same time, same place next week on the Amazon Files.